Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back, Wrestling Paradox Podcast. We are in here, and boy, oh boy, do we have a nice surprise for everybody tonight. But before we get into that, don't forget, M&J Ecological are your sponsors for this show. 305-697-2258. Make sure you guys reach out to Marcus and get all your reptile needs taken care of. If they are taking over your home, he can take them out of there. And we got
they're falling out of trees, right? It's cold. They're falling out of trees. He can make sure he can take care of that.
All your iguanas freeze in South Florida.
Better call Marcus. He helped me out. Like, I'm outside right now because of that. I'd be overrun by some iguanas right now. Sorry.
It's like Australia was overrun by emus back in the 60s. Remember that?
Yeah, they're using Tommy guns and just blowing away these emus. Like, that's great, dude.
All right, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, as you see, there's your special guest for tonight, Nelio Costa, in the building representing CCW, Coastal Championship Wrestling. Yes, sir. CCW, the number one place in South Florida for the past 18 years, in all of Florida in the past 18 years, training all your professional wrestlers, producing some of the biggest names to grace the gorilla position.
The biggest name. The biggest
Austin.
Name.
Oh, Will Austin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
He's the international superstar. Will Austin trained at the CCW training facility.
Yes, the biggest name right now. The biggest unsigned free agent.
It's true.
Hot right now.
All right, Will, what's going on, man? Welcome back to the Paradox.
About time. It took forever for you to get back on here. What's going on?
Well, you know, we had some other arrangements going on. And we're here.
Sounds like excuses to me.
There's a lot of superstars, Will. There's a lot of people, you know, give them their just due, you know.
I guess you got to build up other people to face me, I guess. It true. Is what it is.
So, as you can see, the excitement is building in the room, ladies and gentlemen. We have the man behind the scenes at CCW, and we have the man in front of the scene at CCW, and possibly the biggest face in CCW. I'm sure Cha-Cha Charlie has something to say about that.
I was going
to
say, you got to put a fourth box in there and let them fight it out for who's the face of Coastal Championship Wrestling.
I don't think it can hold both of our egos.
It's true.
We're going to see how many egos it holds, because this week, February 6th, we have Bash at the Brew. And I've been touching up on my brew skills here, my brewsties. So I'm not a big beer fan, but I found a mango one I like. So hopefully Unbranded Brewery, February 6th, has some mango beer for me, because we are there live, ladies and gentlemen, at Bash at the Brew.
There's a surprise. There's an announcement. I guess it's kind of broken a little bit. But, February 6th, we're going to be at Bash at the Brew, Unbranded Brewing Company. But we are already booked for Bash at the Brew Part 2. March 6th. So that will be a monthly show down in Hialeah, down south. And that'll be our beachhead. So this is going to be the big one that kicks it off. It's going to be awesome, but it won't be the last one. So if you can't make it this Saturday, I'm really disappointed in you. You should steal a car if you don't have a vehicle, and you should get there. But you have an opportunity March 6th for 305 weekend down in Miami to see.
It's in Hialeah. It's in Hialeah. That's all they do is steal cars. Are you kidding me?
Exactly. Well, no, it's actually in a great area in Hialeah. It's awesome, because it used to be a weird spot, but you got to check out the Unbranded Brewing Company. It's awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was looking online today. Their food looks amazing. I'm very excited for that.
And it's we were there on a Tuesday, and we had like too many beers, and they had this it's like a coal oven pizza, right? Like a brick oven pizza that was unbelievable. Tasted like I was sitting in a beach in Naples eating a pizza. I was like, this is awesome. And then I was like, I can't wait till the fans eat it. And it's not. It's barbecue on Saturdays. So I if the barbecues are as good as this pizza, like, you should be excited.
Is there wrestling there too? Because you had me at the food.
Wrestling? Yeah, right. Beer and food. Oh, yeah, there's a wrestling show too.
Well, since there is a wrestling show, we have Will Austin on that card. And who do we have Will Austin going against? I believe I heard Jackal.
Will Austin, he was going to be wrestling the Jackal. I think this is a match, obviously, two of the best workers in Coastal Championship Wrestling. The Jackal had one of the best Southeastern title
reigns,
you know, in a long time. You know, he made that Southeastern Championship hot. He lost to Bugs Moran. And, you know, obviously, Will has had some CCW heavyweight championship opportunities, but I think this is a good match because it will solidify, you know, one or the other to take that next step, you know, in regards to the heavyweight championship or the Southeastern championship or this brand new belt I'm calling it the OCCW, the Original Coastal Championship Wrestling, 24/7, 365 Interpromotional Championship that Jackal won two Saturdays ago. Joe, you were there. You did the commentary. You did the play by play on that. So will that come into play? Maybe it will. You know, it's 24/7, 365. Does it mean that it
there's only one belt in CCW that matters? That's the money weight. That's what I carry because everybody wants a match with me.
I was gonna ask.
Fuck all that other stuff. Everyone keeps calling me out.
The clout weight championship.
How do you feel about this match? I think that's what everybody's wondering because you're the reason we're here tonight. This is all about Will Austin. This is Will Austin night. It is Tuesdays of Will Austin. So
Jackal is someone who's I've said it multiple times. At CCW right now, do I think I'm the best there? Obviously, Jackal's a close number two. So this is we haven't had a match in years. So this is obviously he's gotten better. I've gotten better. I've been traveling. So now I'm back to this one. This is going to be a can't miss one, especially on my roller coaster year of 2021. This is a career year for me after everything I've done so far. And Jacko's just going to add that might top off the year so far. And we're only in February.
You're very correct. Well, we're going to dip our toes into what 2021 has brought Will Austin so far. But I have to ask if you get the pin this weekend or the submission 1, 2, 3, whatever it is with the clout chairs that you most recently named it. Are you the 24/7 365 champion? Is that what you become if you
win? Oh, absolutely. That belt is on the line 24 hours.
I mean, just make sure.
You're going to win it and what, throw it in the trash? What are you, a Lundra Blaze? Like, give me a break, Will. I mean, you've been Jackal, you win the belt.
I only won one, and that's the world title. All the other belts are pass that off. I want the world title. That's the only thing that matters in this business.
He's going to walk out and hand it to Benny Blanco as he's going in the bathroom.
I just might give him.
Guys, no spoilers.
Another guy getting fucking popular because I said his name once. Another guy who's fucking eating off my clout.
Seriously. I know that he had a big angle at the OCW show. I never even heard of this guy before, so I don't know.
Apparently he was on a big losing streak until that.
Yeah, you know, I thought New York produced winners, but
and he still lost. All he did was turn his back on us.
Yeah, right. He didn't win, right?
He didn't even win a match.
Nope. There you go.
So anyway, his claim to fame is he got the stunner, Jake St. Patrick. Good for you, pal.
Did he win that match?
Nope.
I don't remember.
Nope. anyway, Will Austin. That's why we're here. So 2021 has been great to Will Austin, and that has to do a lot with Puerto Rico. And I want to hear the story, man. I want to hear, you know, recently you made it to the finals of the tournament, and unfortunately you came up short in that tournament. So dive into it, man. Give us the breakdown. What happened down there?
Puerto Rico, obviously I got handpicked because of the talent I have, which it was a blessing just to even go over there with the Colones and the whole Savio Vega was there, Carlos Colon, the dad. It was a dream come true over there. It was literally a WWE setup over there, pretty much. You had agents backstage, and they put us in a bubble and to isolate us from everybody so we could focus on wrestling. And we did a whole cruiserweight, I wouldn't say a cruiserweight tournament because I'm not a cruiserweight. I would say we did a junior heavyweight tournament, and you may say junior heavyweight, but it still proves who's the best wrestler in the world, because those talent over there are, I'm telling you, the people I've wrestled over there and the people I've seen up close and personal over there, dude, I'd put those against anybody, especially the guy I went to the finals against, Justin Dynamite. 26 years old, only been wrestling for 14 years.
You got to love Puerto Rico. You got to love that you can start when you're 11 years old, you know? It's unbelievable. And they get that leg up in Mexico, in Puerto Rico, and other countries that they can train when they're 11. They can train when they're 12 years old. But it shows you need to wrestle. You need to wrestle 10 years. 11 years before you're really good, and those guys get there much quicker. So more power to Justin and congratulations to him. But I'm sure you're going to want a rematch for that, and I'm sure you're going to see him again in the near future, whether that's in Florida or Puerto Rico or, you know.
If you don't run back me and Justin Dynamite, you're losing money on that easily. Same thing with me and Sebastian Cage. If we do a one and done on a draw, especially what we did, the excitement and a first time touching New York versus Florida and what we did in that match, even if you don't run that match back, you're losing money.
Yeah, actually, that's a great part to I can jump in. And Sebastian Cage will be at Enter the Machine in Nashville in 3 weeks, and then we'll be doing three dates for Coastal Championship Wrestling in March already. So Sebastian Cage will be a familiar face around CCW, I think, for a little bit. And I think he proved himself in that match. And yeah, I'd like to have seen a decisive winner myself. We'll see. I'm sure you guys will see each other again.
I'm calling it a lock right now. If we're both on the 17th anniversary show, March 20th, I don't see why not Will Austin versus Sebastian Cage too, to prove who really is the best.
I like it. I like it.
Wrestling Paradox Podcast. This is the place to be, ladies and gentlemen.
You see, I put out a quote after that first match, shut down pro wrestling in 2021 after what me and Sebastian did, and that was in January. No one's topping that. Are you kidding me?
Will, don't jinx it. They had to shut down pro wrestling in 2020 already. Let's not jinx it again, brother. Please. But yeah, no.
I mean,
the match.
If we're going out on me and Sebastian, I wouldn't want it any other way. No one's topping that. Might as well shut down the shows. No one's going to even touch that.
Next week on a live wrestling, 7
the greatest match I'll ever be in. And it was Raw.
Next week, a live wrestling, 7 p.m. Eastern time. That match will start the show. So don't be late. Don't jump in the live premiere late. Watch it. Sebastian Cage and Will, he spoiled the ending, but it's that good. You want to watch it anyway. It's wonderful. So that match will be on a live wrestling next Tuesday.
That was an amazing.
And then, I mean, you're also going to be in a high profile match. I don't want to. I mean, is it a spoiler if everybody knows about it? The results are on Cage Match, but if you want to be surprised, don't look up the results. But then Will and Sebastian the next night got things together in a little bit of a different way. But yeah, this won't be the last time Sebastian Cage and Will Austin face in Coastal Championship Wrestling.
Anywhere we face, I'm going to New York. They're running the Mega Slam. I'm going to be a surprise entrance, and I'm going to run that, and me and
Don't
Sebastian.
Spoil surprises, man.
Stop
spoiling the surprises.
Hey, I could show up. I could not if they pay me enough. I'm at the point right now after I'm turning off 2021 that it's like, if they pay me enough, maybe I'll show up. If not.
I respect that.
Man, Will Austin, you are always something else to have on this show. All right. I mean,
you had a great match that we just put up online on the YouTube against Super Crazy, which is episode one of a live wrestling. And we're 20, that's 20 weeks ago, which is like, it blows my mind. It's 20
that's
weeks
crazy.
Ago you had that match. It feels like yesterday and also feels like 10 years ago simultaneously. But Super Crazy will be back. He'll be back for three dates in March as well. So hopefully we'll get to see that match as well. Definitely not at the anniversary show because, I have an announcement to make later in the show. You won't be wrestling Super Crazy then. He'll be wrestling somebody else. But definitely, hopefully, that Friday.
I've already beat him. What other business do I have with him?
Exactly.
I started off a live wrestling. The only way you can is put me in the main event. I started the charge by beating the legend. What else? How can you go from there?
Since and it was a shock. Look, I mean, I'll be honest. I mean, it was pretty much.
It was a shock to you guys. I knew it was going to happen all along. I'm the best unsigned. I'm the best unsigned. I've been in it.
You have the insane luchador. You have a legend. Obviously, Will, you're incredibly talented. But, I mean, at the time, it was an upset. Maybe now it's not an upset. But
it was a shock to everyone but me.
Hey, anything can happen. And a live wrestling in CCW, you know, anything can happen.
Man, Will, does your head fit through doors regularly now? Or
it fits on the camera. You see this.
That's a miniature sized tree, everybody.
Yeah, actually that painting of a tree is just a normal tree. All that sunlight's actually from Will.
That's a nice shirt you got there, Joe.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, exactly. Paying tribute to the King of Play.
So I mean, I think everybody's asking the question, and I'm not sure where it's gonna pay off to, but we all heard Marina Tucker's interview last week.
Who?
CCW had the floor, Marina Tucker. This is, I mean, Raw Underground. You know, she's done a lot of stuff, Will, you know, former WXW champion, but go ahead.
So she starts off by saying, I'm in ninth grade and I'm the face of a company. I don't care how young, you better be in your 30s, maybe 40s, talking about that rah-rah shit. I'm the one of the youngest there and I'm leading the pack because I'm the best one there. Are you kidding me? First, I know
she's a young.
She says she wants an intergender match and she would love to wrestle me. And as far as catching me more than these independent guys on the indie scene, she's probably right. Because now, I don't think she really knows what she's asking for because she says she's that bitch, but she's just a bitch. I will send her back down to the women's division.
I'm trying not to get the show canceled, please.
I will send her back down to the women's division, not where she came from, but to the bottom of the fucking barrel. I promise you, me versus Marina Tucker, I will embarrass her.
Well, I mean, you guys compete in completely different divisions, so it's not unusual for a difficult
up there a talented with me to step up in competition. It's not unusual for them to want to test it, but it's a whole other ball game when you get in there with me.
Yeah, I mean, look, obviously it's an intriguing matchup. You know, it's intriguing. You know, Marina has she has some stuff going on. You know, she's chasing her title back. You know, she has a lot of stuff going on, but who
makes
knows?
Sense. I would say she's the best female. She's the best woman wrestler we have right now. I'm the best men's wrestler we have right now. It makes sense, but it's a whole nother level when you step in there with me.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, it's going to be interesting. We'll see what happens. You know, it's an interesting thing. You know, you guys are going to both be in the building in March 6th, probably. You know,
I don't know. Really? Because every time I show up, she's nowhere to be found. Will we be in the same building?
You guys are thieves in the night. You guys are passing. You know, she's ducking you. Will, I think.
Yeah, what for the best? You know, talked about she can catch me better than these most of the men on the indie scene. Yeah, but you're nowhere to be found on age. You catch me, right?
I feel like I'm sitting back and just watching you guys now. Yeah. At this point, it's cool. I like it, man. It's awesome.
No, to Marina's credit,
who's gonna stop me? I'm having a career year in 2021. An intergender match would be up there in the list of what I want to do for sure. Marina's the best one we have. I would love to mix it with Marina, but I'm gonna embarrass her. It's a whole nother level from a step up in competition if you say you want to get in the ring with me. But everyone's doing it nowadays because they want match tonight. They want that cloud off of my name. Oh, I want Will Austin because I want match of the night. Bro, I can wrestle myself and have match of the night.
They want that bonus. They want the best match bonus, you know, at the end of the night. I understand. Hey, I would too, you know, if you get that extra, you know, $500 in your pocket for the best match bonus for CCW and everybody wants it.
I can't bless everybody, but eventually I'll try.
Well, Will, you've definitely had your run-ins with everybody, and as of
recently. How'd that one go? Tell me how that one went.
With who?
With everybody. Who came out on top? Let me know how that one went.
Well, here's one thing. So recently you had a run-in with the CCW tag team champion, Ariel Levy. And I have to ask, are you nervous of the repercussions of possibly his tag team partner, Vinicius, going after you?
Not the Brazilian Giant. Not one bit. I talk a big game because I back it up. You see what I do in the ring. Who impresses you more than me? I will take them all. The night I won my tag team titles from American Horror Story, Mick Foley introduced me to the ring. I told Mick Foley I will do this one-on-two. Not a problem. So
no, and you, the same thing when you wrestled the Colognes, you petitioned hard to go one-on-two with Eddie and Orlando Cologne. Unfortunately, or fortunately, however the case is, management didn't allow that to happen. That's just not how things are done so far. But, you know, obviously, I think out of the group there of the you know, the Brazilian Destroyer and Ariel Levy, I think the scariest guy is Bill Alfonso, because what he does in the background, what he's always around, he's always lurking around, whether that be, you know, like politicking to management or literally jumping into rings, taking refs' shoes off. So, I mean, obviously that's a match that we're going to want to see again. We're going to want to see it in Coastal Championship Wrestling.
I mean, will it though? Bill Alfonso is involved. Like, this guy was famous 40 years ago when I was even born. They remember him because of the whistle, but did they really want to see him? Come on.
Bill's the man, yo. Come on now. Have some respect for some legends around here.
No, I don't get me wrong. Daddy. I have respect for the legends who paved the way, but not when you keep trying to come back and make that name off of the name you made 30 years ago.
But look what he's done with Rob Van Dam and with Sabu and someone of your talent. Well, maybe
down the road,
you know, like, you know, RVD was a very raw, unbelievable talent, probably one of the best wrestlers in the world at the time. And you're cut, I think, from a very similar cloth to Rob Van Dam. Maybe that's the type of person down the road. Yeah, obviously not now. I know he has some contractual obligations. I know you're your own man, but just down the road, who knows, you know? Something to think
maybe
about.
We'll be reading the King of Flight book one day.
Look at that.
You know, maybe we'll be reading that book.
That's one of those. I faced Sabu. I've faced almost every legend that we brought in, and I've knocked it out the park every time.
You're doing that, and CCW doesn't have reason to hold you back, man. You got to just keep fighting and keep pushing.
Yeah, let me.
You have the biggest name for them right now. Come, Will, you constantly think someone's holding you back, or you're not.
Well, who is the biggest name right now in CCW?
You're one of the biggest names in CCW.
I'm not one of. I am the. I'm not one of the biggest names. I am the biggest name.
Okay. Let me finish. We know how big your head is. That's fine. But you know, Will, like, I'm wearing your shirt and I support you, but what would CCW's reason be to hold you back? You feel like you're getting held back? No, man, they're pushing you to the top. You're facing their biggest names. Like, why are you, you know, everybody that
I thought one of the best matches in your career, Will, was the match with Sebastian Cage. And I think one of your top matches as well was Hector Perfecto a few weeks before. I think it's just up from here, you know. And if you look at the amazing talent, look, Matthew Justice. That's another announcement.
He's one of those that he can do more than deathmatch, and he's one of those I would love to wrestle. Not in deathmatch, but I would love, because I know he can go.
Matthew Justice will be there for Enter the Machine. He will be there for Anniversary 17. That's new. That was signed this morning. He'll be there for Anniversary 17. And as a little extra bonus, he'll be there at St. Lucie Showdown. So I think there might be an opportunity to wrestle. Look, Matthew Justice, say what you will about him, but he's the type of guy who turned the WWE down, just flat out. Said, I'm just not into that. So you have a guy in his 20s who's built like a machine. Bill Alfonso is his manager. Coming in, Will, I'm telling you, like, there's so many opportunities. Sebastian Cage, Hector Perfecto, Matthew Justice. And how about guys on the roster? Look, I know you and Cha-Cha Charlie, I know that we're dancing around it. You guys have unfinished business. Cha-Cha Charlie says he's the John Cena of CCW. He says he is the the man who's been here, bringing the children, bringing the women, bringing the, you know, grandmothers. You have Santos, obviously. You know Santos very well, who calls himself.
Yeah, he's been bringing the children so they can piss in their pants every time they see him. I'm bringing the grown women and men that want to see a real man.
So, you know, you were dancing around it, but those are really the match people want to see is one-on-one Will Austin, Cha-Cha Charlie, one-on-one Will Austin and El Jefe Santos.
But what's the consistent name in there, one-on-one?
Will Austin.
There you go. Enough said.
But you did it to yourself. One thing about Coastal Championship Wrestling is we're crowded at the top. I mean, you have a lot of really good – look at Jackal. Jackal took –
you can book Will Austin versus Joe from the podcast, and they just want to see it because of Will Austin.
Okay. You look at a guy like Jackal. Jackal, I think, is in his period. If you watch Shawn Michaels in 1994 and a half, where he just comes off that Intercontinental title reign, and he's just kind of found himself. Like, he found his voice. Like, he found out who he is. And every moment on screen from, like, 94 to 98, Shawn Michaels was just golden. And I have a feeling we're about to see that 3-year run from Jackal that is just golden. So that's another guy that, look, he did, you know, he's not the same size as Santos, and he's not the same size as Cha-Cha Charlie, you know, and he's a bigger guy, and you're not a cruiserweight anymore as well.
Don't get me wrong. If anyone, I speak highly of Jackal. I'll tell you, he's a close second to me, but he's not number one.
Yeah, and he's an assistant trainer now at the place, and he's getting better every single day. So you have Jackal, have Alex Ocean. Look, Alex Ocean he's doing this deathmatch thing. He likes his things. You know, you have a lot of guys up top. Agony was a heavyweight champion for a long time. You have these guys that are still around. Will,
I'm the type that comes to these guys and challenges them in their own match. I challenged a year ago, me and Alex, in a deathmatch because I wanted to go to his territory.
Yeah.
I'll do the same thing. I'll go wherever Jackal wants to go with this 24/7. I'll meet him backstage if that's what he wants. I'll go down to the women's division and lower myself
You'll go down to the junkyard with Bugs Moran. You'll go into the rail yard.
Yeah, that's one I won't do. You can have the hepatitis.
Bugs lives in.
I will lower myself. Go down to the women's division just so I can embarrass Marina.
Nelio, did I tell you how happy he was when you just called?
To their territory, just to embarrass him.
No, I understand. Unfortunately, in CCW, a man can't hold the women's championship.
I don't need a women's title to tell me I'm the best. I have the money weight title. I know I'm the best. I don't need another championship to tell me that.
Understood. Yes, so my dog loves you.
Apparently. Women love me, men love me, kids love me, dogs love me.
They love it.
What's going on, guys?
So, Will Austin, we asked you last time, where do you see yourself in 5 years? And we didn't know Puerto Rico was happening. Now Puerto Rico happened. What's the next 3 years for Will Austin?
Oh, secret's out now. Yeah, I went to Puerto Rico. I conquered over there. I'm going back because I have unfinished business, and that's huge. I'm telling you, ever since I came back from Puerto Rico, it's been, dude, the amount of people I've got on social media that just keep telling me I'm the future because they see me on Puerto Rican TV. I've been doing this from day one. Now that I went to another out of the U.S., Puerto Rico's U.S. territory, now that I went to that island to conquer it, now they're seeing it too. So where I see myself in 5 years, I see the best unsigned right now. At least in 5 years, I see myself signed.
Yeah, I was going to say, Will, I mean, I would challenge you right now, like 5 years from now, you know, you should be in NXT or you should be in All Elite Wrestling. Or if there's another company that exists that is like a national television somewhere, you should be on national television. And before you should go to Japan, you should go to Mexico. You should go to those places, you know, so I would challenge you, you know, I know you're challenging yourself. But I would challenge you, Will, to be signed, you know, in that.
I'm scary right now in 2021. Imagine with me in 5 years.
Exactly. Exactly. Well, maybe we'll see CCW live wrestling on Fox Sports or something.
Yeah, it'll be on Fox Sports. I have a couple of announcements as well, you know.
Yeah. Guys, tell us something.
We're the duck. We're like a duck, you know, like we're completely serene. Everything is, you know, and then under the water, things are flying, you know,
it's
like
going crazy right now.
So you'll see some deals coming in for CCW as well. But if in 5 years, if in 10 years, if NXT wants Will Austin, sign with NXT.
Yeah. Well, that was
All Elite Wrestling. Like, yeah. No.
I've hit Jake St. Patrick through this question.
Whoever's throwing the most money.
I've hit Marina Tucker with this question. If there's equal contracts of AEW and WWE, which one are you picking up?
It depends. Whoever the talent over there, whoever entices me more to go wrestle them.
Right now,
yeah, you have.
Well, do you watch the shows? Well, who entices you most from those?
Yeah, who do you want to work with? Who do you want? Do you want to see yourself on Wednesday nights or Monday nights?
I would love to go to Japan and mix it up with Will Ospreay.
I love the answer. You're the first person avoiding this question. That's fine. I'll take it.
He wants to be on Access TV. Are they on Access anymore? No, New Japan is the place to be, and
Well, yeah, they're in California right now, I believe. They're shooting out of California, I've heard. That's what I heard last, that they were...
The New Japan Strong or whatever.
Yeah, New Japan Strong. They're recording out of California because Mox was over there a couple weeks ago.
But that's one of those. Obviously, everyone's going to want to go to WWE. That's a childhood dream. But now, WWE, you don't have to go to WWE to make it. But obviously, everyone, if they tell you they wouldn't want to be in WWE, is lying to you. Even Matt Justice, who turned down a contract. Would he want to be in WWE one day? Of course. Who wouldn't?
No, but he had the opportunity.
He had the opportunity. And if they wanted to switch his gimmick or something like that, that's on him. But
I don't know the details. I don't know all the details.
If you tell me right now WWE signed you and you're saying no based on anything other than that you just don't want to go there, you're lying to yourself.
Sounds like a great.
It sounds like Matt Justice is the only one that has the answer. You know, so
let's have Matthew on the show.
And please answer my DMs, Matt. I did go Browns.
Let's have Matt on the show and let me co-host. Let's have Matt on.
There. Wait, let's get him on right now.
I wanted it from the horse. There's a reason Nelio's on.
You want to go with the real hard hitting questions? He's another one who does the death matches too. I will meet him in a death match in his own territory.
Well, we saw that at homecoming day number two. Him and Alex Ocean tore the house down.
That'll be on, I think, in 2 weeks or 3 weeks on Live Wrestling. That's going to be insane. I think I might have to. I might not be able to put that on Live Wrestling. I might have to put that on like Vimeo and just put it on the website because I don't not want to be banned. I don't want the channel to be banned.
That match was pretty hectic.
It was pretty hectic, but it'll be up. It'll be up in some way or form in CCW and available.
I'm not going to spoil anything, but Alex Ocean hit that dumpster hard. I was standing right next to it, dude. It was disgusting.
What do you have a dumpster in a death match? That's
it was
a shit.
Thud, man.
It was from the previous tenant.
Yeah. It was just
you can't be messing with Bugs' home like that.
Yeah, exactly. Bugs wrote it in.
He is the face this week for Bash at the Brew, ladies and gentlemen, February 6th, this Saturday.
He will be defending his title against Miami Mike Saturday. His first title defense in a long time. So, you know, it's going to be an interesting match.
I'm waiting for the counterpart of Miami Mike, Broward Billy.
I love it.
I think it would be like, I think it's like the counterpart is like Miami Midge.
March.
Pompano Pete. I can just do this all day. Be here for 2 hours, Will. You know?
All right, man. Will Austin, this has been awesome so far.
You're welcome.
As behind the scenes of CCW, do you have some questions for Will Austin? You want to clear the air right now?
No, I think Will's done a wonderful job as of late. I think he's really stepped his game up as of late, wrestling wise, you know, and then also just being a leader for CCW and leading the cause and the brand and stuff has been great. You know, like, you know, it's hard because, you know, you have so much things to do, like, you know, as a professional wrestler now, you can't just be a wrestler anymore. You used to be like, oh, I'm a wrestler. Now I'm a video editor. I'm doing sound. Now I'm like doing social media stuff. Now you have to book yourself. You have to do all this stuff. So, you know, it's not easy. And Will's doing a great job doing that on top of being a great wrestler. So I only have good things to say about Will.
I think you put anybody in my spot and they will fold. I'm going out. This past weekend, I just faced Blanco Loco, who's one of the biggest names on the indie scene right now. That's one I've been wanting. And I'm earning a respect of every that video's going online of me and Blanco hugging after the match. Videos online of me and Sebastian hugging after the match. All these top talent I keep calling out and get fed to me. And I'm, again, you put anybody else in my situation, they're not going to do what I'm doing.
Sure. You know, it's hard because, you know, wrestling has changed, you know, and there's different styles of wrestling. And definitely your style is so your style is definitely like, it's obviously it's interesting and it's something that captivates people and it's wonderful. So when you bring in like you and Sebastian have excellent chemistry, obviously Blanco Loco, excellent chemistry. You know, what I'm thinking about sometimes, Will, is, you know, maybe these mismatches, you know, I don't know if you know Beastman, if you've heard of Beastman before, 400 pounds. He's been all over the independent scenes. Great guy. And he will be down in CCW as well. For some dates coming up, that's the type of match, you know, Will, wrestle, look, Blanco Loco, of course, Sebastian Cage, of course, Hector Perfecto, great, Ariel Levy, great, man, you need to go and wrestle a Beast Man or wrestle a Botavian. Have you wrestled Botavian yet? You know, branching out into some different body types. You know?
The only time I got in the ring with Botavian, me and Johnny Walker was victorious against that. You can match me up against whoever you want. Have you seen me wrestle
Big Agony? English.
I take down the big man. I'm a giant killer. I just mesh well with the people who's my style because
he's a giant killer.
He's a giant killer. Will Austin.
And there is a giant out there, and I believe he's from Brazil.
South America. Yeah, he's a big dude.
Big dude. Line
he's crazy.
Maybe
you can't book him out against anybody.
Had a running with Ariel Levy a couple weeks ago, so maybe.
Yeah, obviously
new tag team. Might want to watch you back at Bash at the Brew. That's all.
Obviously new tag team champions. They defeated Carlito, who was on Raw with an amazing body. His body is like ridiculous. When
he brought it, sometimes he wrestles in a shirt, and I'm just like, dude, like
why? Why? I mean, not to sound like a weirdo, but why? And then Eddie Colon and Carlito against the South American Alliance. And this is another announcement, South American Alliance on anniversary, if they're still the tag team champions, because they are going to be wrestling the Assassins at Bash at the Brew, and they will be wrestling a few other guys in between. If they're still, they will be wrestling former WWE World Tag Team Champions, the Headbangers, Mosh, and Thrasher, coming back to CCW to try to take their titles away. So, right, I mean, they are motivated. They saw that. They saw what happened with Carlito. They saw what happened with Eddie Colon, and they are motivated. So, come Anniversary 17 at CCWrestlingFL.com. You get to watch the Headbangers. You get to watch the Brazilian Giant, Bill Alfonso, Ariel Levy. It's going to be amazing.
I'm just there for the Brazilian Giant.
Amazing match, dude. I'm so excited for Mosh and Thrasher. but speaking of great tag teams, I do have a question.
Headbangers,
Will Austin,
former WWE tag team champions.
So is Will Austin, is the Magnificent Clout still tag team champ or still a tag team? You and Johnny Walker. Are you?
You want to go to rephrase that one? The Magnificent Clout or the Magnificent Drill?
Magnificent Drill. They are still in the tag team ranks, but they did submit that they would prefer.
I'm in my own rank. I fuck a tag team. I'm in my own rank. I tell you, I'm the money weight. Johnny still got my back, but I'm in my own rank. Everybody wants me. Johnny will be there when I come back.
You and Johnny.
Yeah, officially, I think it was Johnny Walker's lawyer did submit that they prefer to enter the heavyweight division. So they're not in the tag team rankings, but obviously that can change at any moment if they decide.
All right.
But there's no heat there, Will. I mean, you and Johnny, you're still.
No, me and like Johnny came on here, what, 2 weeks ago, last week? He said Will Austin is Johnny Walker's guy and Johnny Walker is Will Austin's guy. We're still closer than ever. It's, you got to understand too, in this business, you're always looking out for number one. And, you know, there's some people like the Dudley Boys who, oh, we only wanted to be tag team wrestlers. Like, all right, that's cool. But at the end of the day, you're looking out for numero uno, and that's yourself. But yeah, Johnny Walker's still my guy. I'm still his guy. And it's, dude, with the way my year is going, the way I'm tearing this up in 2020, I'm setting the indie scene on fire. You can't stop me right now by putting me in a tag team.
The guy has spoken. The man has spoken.
I mean, that being said, I love tag team wrestling.
I do too. I love it. I love it.
You know, I think obviously, you know, to be a world heavyweight champion is like, that's the top. You know, the belt that Santos has is the top belt in Florida.
That's a fucking paper belt as far as I'm concerned. You want to talk about tag team wrestling? I carried those belts around by myself.
Yeah, you increased the prestige of that belt. You increased the prestige of that belt. And now you're saying that belt is not, you know, on par with some of the greatest tag team belts. The lineage of that belt, the tracks back to Florida Championship Wrestling.
I'll tell
Dustin
you why.
Rhodes and Dustin Rhodes on those belts, those tag team belts. You held the belts longer, I think, than any of them.
And look where they went. So they went to some of our part-timers who can't come in due to COVID. Now, I didn't have a partner for 2 years because of COVID, and I still carry those belts around, both of them, by myself because I was the tag team division.
But Orlando and Eddie Colon and then Carlito Colon, I mean, they were great champions. They were great tag team champions as well. They're great. I mean, obviously, you know, working with them in WWC, they're great competitors, hopefully to be back soon. My fear is Carlito being signed by the WWE this week, probably. Yeah, they saw him and they said, look at him. So, you know, that's a guy that, you know, you want to see 4, 6, 7, 8 times a year in CCW, but you're probably going to end up seeing him 52 times a year on SmackDown or whatever.
Yeah,
but,
who knows? I got the call. I got a text from Uncle Dave Meltzer earlier, and he told me Carlito's on a three-date appearance contract, and it's basically a tryout like they did with MVP.
And look what happened.
Bring him back.
MVP, former CCW World Heavyweight Champion.
Exactly. You like where I went with that, right?
This is Dave Meltzer, like, well, you know, three dates, you know, things could change. I don't know, but three probably dates.
And stick around. And,
you got to throw in a brother in there somewhere. Brother!
So, you know, and it's a little disappointing, back to the tag team thing really quick. It's a little disappointing with Will and Johnny kind of going to separate ways, because the tag team division is CCW. They say the tag team division in AEW is stacked. Obviously, you haven't looked at South Florida, because this CCW tag team division is stacked. It hits out the ballpark every match. I mean,
you're welcome, because I started that.
Well, thank you, Will Austin. Again,
some say Will Austin started the tag team revolution.
When I carried around both of those belts by myself, I was defending them in every match. Imagine I was defending them in singles matches, because I would run and raise the prestige of those titles that I'll put them on the line every single time I went out there. And now we have a whole loaded tag team division.
Entirely. Yeah. You have the Assassins, you have the Cha-Cha Juggernauts. You have Controversial Inc. You have Agony and Jackal, Agony and Alex. You have, you know, it's insane.
All these tag team division is loaded.
Yeah. Sage Scott, Jake St. Patrick. You have the Cologne still hanging out. You have the Headbangers now, or you did before, but now they're back. Who else do you have? I have some potential announcements coming up in a couple weeks. You know, some potential.
Fuck it, drop it now. Coming in. Fuck it, just drop it now.
I don't want to put the cart before the horse. Calm down. I want to get the ink dry on the contract before I say anything, just in case.
Yeah,
We have two guys who wrestle pretty regularly on All Elite Wrestling, and they are interested in doing some business. And they're both interesting. Will, I think you've actually wrestled one before. But it looks like we might have something going on in the near future with that. So that's all I'll say. But announcement coming soon.
I have no idea. I'm in the kayfabe just as much. I don't know nothing right now. So here's my thing. Will Austin, at homecoming, after your first match, you grabbed a microphone with Sebastian Cage, and you gave your respect to Sebastian Cage, and you looked directly in the camera. And you said, this is my house, and it's the door is open for anybody. If you think you're the best, come in and challenge me. who are you looking at when you say that? Because Sebastian Cage has already checked off. You
guys are gonna have Ospreay, that probably. It's Ospreay.
Is it Ospreay?
Anybody and everybody. Like, the top of my list right now is Leo Rush.
Okay.
Yeah, Leo Rush and Myron Reed, and that's about it. Just
Leo Rush's wife just had a child, but once the baby's a little bit older, I think that's
if there's another step up in competition, it would be Leo Rush.
Yeah.
That's
me and Nelly will talk about that.
Me and Sebastian have unfinished business. So that's one I said I could wrestle him any day of the week and twice on Sunday, and you're always gonna get something new and exciting out of it.
How about I'll throw a name in there that's already been in discussion. Unfortunately, some of the dates haven't worked out but Calvin Tankman. If you watch MLW, Calvin Tankman is a tank, man. He is badass, and I want to see him ASAP. But the dates just haven't worked out exactly right. But I expect him to be, hopefully, I mean, until he's signed by All Elite Wrestling or he's signed by WWE or whatever, to be another guy who's going to come in at least 4, 5, 6 times a year and light the company on fire.
I would also say we got somebody coming into Nashville, Casey Navarro, who's lighting
New York. Oh, yeah. Tonight he had a barn burner with a Phoenix, right?
Unbelievable. Dude, like he's lighting it on fire right now, and it's just like, I'm at that same level, so why can't I light it on fire with him?
Well, Casey Navarro is entering the 64-man Cruiserweight Invitational. I know, Will, you're not a Cruiserweight, so you don't want to be in a Cruiserweight Invitational. But someone like Casey Navarro, I think Sebastian Cage is also going to be in it.
If any of those guys, Casey or Sebastian, can make it to the finals, that might entice me.
Okay. So, you know, CCW is crowning the first ever Cruiserweight champion. Again, I know it doesn't entice you, but isn't it interesting to be that first ever Cruiserweight champion, especially on an unheard of field of 64 competitors? I mean, it's like, look, I love college basketball. And I don't watch college basketball all year, but that freaking tournament, I love
March Madness.
Yeah, I love the March Madness, right? So I know it's not March. Wait, it is. Is March.
Next month.
Yeah, I'm an idiot. So 64 teams, Cruiserweight Invitational, the new March Madness, CCW March Madness for the first ever CCW Cruiserweight Champion. Obviously, you have favorites. You have Casey Navarro is a favorite. Sebastian Cage is a favorite. Jake St. Patrick is a favorite. So you have guys that you know are going to go the distance. You know they're going to get into, you know, hopefully into that final. And Will, I would put your name there too if you were interested. But, you know, I think the brackets are basically done.
You got to build these guys up to face me in the finals. You got to build something up. That's good business.
Declaring you the number one contender for the person who does win. So, you know, could it be Casey Navarro against Will Austin for the Cruiserweight Championship? But I don't know. I like to, you know, who was the winner of the CWC, the first CWC?
I'll wait to the final. I'll take my time off, let everybody else catch up. If that's what needs to be for everybody else to get on my level, I'll wait to the final.
You would be the Kota Ibushi of that tournament, and you're missing out, man.
I'm the favorite in anything I'm in.
Will, could you imagine if Ospreay had went to that tournament and won, and he'd be in WWE right now? How different the wrestling landscape would be. Anyway,
I think it's smart that he didn't go because look, he's tearing it up right now. He's been tearing it up the past couple of years.
Yeah, who knows? He could be, you know, he could be dancing on SmackDown like with a dancing gimmick with Ricochet or something.
Please don't destroy his
who knows, like man? That. They could be like the Hurricane Part Two.
You can come in.
Hurricane's former CCW tag champion who was in the Royal Rumble as well.
Yeah.
You can come in at NXT or you can make your debut like AJ Styles on the main roster.
There you go. Well, he actually made his debut at Royal Rumble. So it's.
He has a main roster.
Well, who knows? There's right? NXT guys in there too.
Like Rusev at the time. What year was that? Like it was 16?
Like 16.
Is that 16? 15? Tyler Breeze coming out?
I was there. Yeah, I'm sure. That was you're Orlando. Right. Everyone thought. AJ was going to go to NXT. It was weird at the time, right? That he went to the main roster. They should do that with guys more often.
What, straight to the main roster?
Straight to the main roster.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Sign Will Austin. Let's get this shit rolling.
Yeah, no, we'll just go right to say,
I'm trying to ride this coattail to the top.
I want to be on SmackDown, and I need my manager to be the Paradox, Joe.
That's exactly. What Thank you.
Dude, I told them months ago, saddle up, because I'm taking them to the top. So everywhere I go, they're going to be – Daddy. It's going to be a bumpy ride. But
it is not bad, Daddy. You should strap the rocket to him.
It's going to be a bumpy ride, but hold on.
You know, we talked about a lot tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We talked about Will Austin versus Marina Tucker. If that will ever happen. Will Austin as a cruiserweight. Will Austin.
I don't think she wants it. She says she's that bitch, but she's just a bitch.
Oh, man. That's twice. I do not want to get canceled.
I think she wants it.
Paying the FCC, sir.
She said something about, like, oh, will my mom be at the show? She comes to kick my ass at? I pray she can try to kick my ass. I told you, I'm going to send you back down to the bottom of the barrel of the women's division.
Well, ladies, I mean, that's – I don't think we'll see that in CCW. I'm sorry, man. It's just not – yeah, you know, we're
family. And you lose the money if you don't.
I'll let it happen inside the paradox.
You can't tell me people don't want to see the best women's wrestler CCW has and the best men's wrestler that CCW has go at it.
I think she might get you, Will.
She'll catch you, yeah.
I think she'll get you. I think
she's a good wrestler.
Not on her best day. Are you kidding me?
Well, she has good ground.
She's talking about, like, I better be in ninth grade. She's like almost 40 years old. Like, she ain't moving the same way she used to. Come on now.
Will, you have
I think you look great, Marina. I think you're in the prime of her career.
I think Marina looks amazing. I don't know what this guy's talking about, but Will, you're talking about best days, and you need to have one of your best days this Saturday at Bash at the Brew. CCW presents Bash at the Brew.
That's you're talking about having another day for me.
And you have Will Austin versus Jackal Stevens, and that match is going to tear the house down. This definitely
easily has potential
being matched.
That could be CCW's Shawn Michaels versus Bret Hart. That could be the match that we just keep going back to because it's so damn good. And if you're listening to this and you're 3 hours away from South Florida, just get in the car. Come Saturday, Bash of the Brew, Unbranded Brewing Company. There's going to be awesome barbecue. There's going to be tons of beer. It's going to be in a huge area. It's not going to be at the bar itself. It's in the actual brewery. It's a huge area. So we're going to be able to space people out if safety is ever a concern. And there's going to be some awesome, there is some awesome announcement coming to CCW, and you're going to hear some of those on Saturday. We are putting the first ever Hall of Famer for CCW, the CCW Hall of Fame. Sorry, Will.
Can you do that while I'm still active?
Sorry, Will. It's for only people who are retired, and we're going to be making that announcement.
The people who can't walk anymore from like 30 years ago. Is it Bill Alfonso?
We'll be making that announcement for the first ever CCW Hall of Famer. And there's a lot of people are guessing. This is a lot of potential ones, but this one's a really good one, close to specifically Dan's heart. Is really close to his heart. So
let me give you a spoiler. It's not me.
It's not Will. No, not yet, Will. One day.
Who else
one day,
is just poking the bear at Vinicius and Bill Alfonso?
Who? I'm the best one there. I believe in me. Like Johnny says, more than you believe in me. Who's going to stop me? I'm the best one there.
I think you need to watch your back Saturday, buddy, just to make sure you're safe. Now, I can't watch your back because I will be there as a fan Saturday, unfortunately. So need everybody just to relax with the autographs, guys. I'll see you when I see you. I'll get around to them.
Yeah, but bring him a beer. You listen to his podcast.
Yeah, you listen to bring him podcast.
Bring him a beer. There's a special beer.
Hopefully, Nelio, I have a table slam beer. Set up, you know, a nice table so I can see the ring and, you know, hear you guys. All right, awesome, man. Very excited.
Yeah, for sure.
Very excited. We'll make it
happen. Super crazy.
I'm on the
super
toilet crazy. Seat. That's my table on the toilet seat.
there's also a big potential run in. There's a guy who's going to be there. But
he's talking about me not giving away spoilers. Jesus.
there's a guy who's going to be there, and he's not contracted to have a match, but I'm going to try my best to have him run out of the back and do something. But he's coming as a fan, but he's a pretty big wrestler, and he's signed by a major company. But he'll be there hanging out. Maybe he can come in and kick somebody in the head. Maybe he can say hello. I don't know if it goes against his contract or not, but that'll be something that you might want to come and check out. You at least see him watching the match, you know?
Yeah, there you go. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Little droppings here and there, you know, around the paradox. I love it.
That's what I'm good at. Droppings.
I wanted to make the announcement. You told me to hold off on the announcement that this was going to be a monthly show at Unbranded Brewery.
Yeah, and, I want you. You know what? Break it right now. Break it.
I'm going to break it. We're done here. But, you know, you told me to hold off. So I was just, you know, making sure.
Well, I told you to hold off until tonight.
Tonight it is, baby. Tonight it is.
Make
the announcement again. We'll react as the same.
I'll be like shocked.
All right,
go ahead Joe, the floor is yours. Go ahead, I
want to
hear it.
Oh, you want me to make the announcement now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Try. Ladies and gentlemen, CCW is proud to present every month, once a month, they are going live from Unbranded Brewery. Is it Unbranded Brewery? Unbranded Brewery.
Undanded Brewing Company.
Unbranded
Get it
Brewery
right or
Company.
Pay the price.
Yes, sir.
Wow, this is the first time I'm hearing this. That's for sure.
JC.
This is breaking news. This is the first time I'm hearing
over there. It's amazing. It's been such a great time, so I'm really, really excited.
Nah, man.
There's also another announcement. There will be a hair versus hair match at Anniversary 17. Who the competitors will be, you'll hear on a live wrestling. It won't be Joe.
It will not be.
It won't be anyone else who's bald. It won't be Vic Arson either, but that's going to be cool. A cage match and then a ladder match. That's going to be dropping really soon. Obviously, the ladder match, the first ever women's ladder match for the CCW Women's Championship at Anniversary 17. Is that a story? I don't know.
Yeah, tell me Marina's in that match so you guys can build her up so then she can finally come face Big Daddy Flay.
Marina,
you're going to build her up in that ladder match. Entice me.
Marina Tucker will be in the CCW women's ladder match. Roma Luchadora will be in the CCW ladder match. And the third competitor will be La Brava. She will be in the CCW women's match. Christy James also expressed interest, but she's wrestling Marina in her first CCW match in Nashville. We'll see what happens there, and then we'll make a decision. But as of right now, it's a three-way for the women's championship on a ladder, plus a hair versus hair match, plus a cage match. It's going to be a crazy anniversary show. It's our WrestleMania. All of our feuds are going to end, and we're going to start fresh. We're going to start debuting new people. Joe's going to be in the ring. It's going to be crazy.
Plus the main event. Circle out, blur out somebody versus Will Austin, whoever you want.
Yeah, whoever you want.
Give me Sebastian.
Will Austin, the uncrowned Paradox champion.
Exactly.
That's a spoiler, ladies and gentlemen.
Put that up on above the ring, and it'll be a ladder match: Marina versus Will. That's it.
Yeah, right, for the Paradox Championship.
I don't think her hip will be able to work to make it to the ring.
Oh, come on, Will, have some respect, man.
I will, but you know, you're over here saying I'm like a ninth grade bitch. I'm carrying a company. You're almost out the door.
Out the door. She's in her prime,
spitting fire,
dude.
She was maybe in the prime of wrestling. She's in the prime of her wrestling life.
Oh, come on, Will. Come on, Will.
She's not even hitting a stride. Didn't she just lose the women's championship and blame it on a screw job? She's not even hitting a stride.
How does CCW's authorities handle this guy on a weekly basis?
We just let him talk.
Let me answer that for you. You can't. You gotta stop me.
Nelio, your hair hasn't fallen out yet.
Mine's not yet. Gone. A little bit in the front here, but
Dude, I've heard this guy talk for an hour now. My hair is like, I had a full head when this interview started. Yeah. Go back and look.
You're a clean shave too.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Will Austin, the King of Flight, inside the Paradox for round number two. And Nelio Costa for round number three. Thank you for joining us, my brother. I appreciate this.
Like Bam Bam Bigelow in the triple threat, daddy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I wanted to. Close no, three time. Three time. Three time.
I'm going to do a spinneroonie on my pool right now, man.
I like it.
On my mansion pool. My pool mansion hanging out on the outside, you know.
There
you
go.
Man.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, it's my absolute pleasure. I wanted Nelio on the show tonight because I need that face of CCW in case Will got out of line.
No, Will's great.
I can't control him, you know.
I love it.
You told me you had your hand on the mute button every time my screen lit up to start talking.
Oh, it sounded like you were going through a tunnel. I just kept hitting mute all night.
Guys, go to ccwrestlingfl.com, St. Lucie Showdown, Port St. Lucie, March 19th, Anniversary 17th on the 20th, and then a theater show that's finally going to be announced, the Cruiserweight Invitational. There's so much stuff happening.
Subscribe to CCW Alive Wrestling on YouTube.
Yes, and then, of course, you know, follow Will on Twitter, get ready_10.
And on Instagram, get_ready13. Follow me on YouTube, Will Austin. Follow podcasts on YouTube.
100%. No, follow as much of Will as possible because you're going to see an explosion. Now that he's wrestling at WWC, he's got a bunch of awesome opponents on CCW. I think he might have the most matches on a live wrestling so far. I think
that's just good
ridiculous.
Business.
What do
you
ridiculous. Even
say?
Great business. That's great business. Yes, make sure you guys follow.
Ridiculous.
For Will Austin, make sure you guys follow the Wrestling Paradox podcast at Podcast Paradox or Paradox Podcast.
Oh, one more thing. I'm so sorry. There's a kid. There's a freaking awesome kid. And we had put together a little package for a live wrestling today, but it was like it was crazy. We had like a crazy deadline today. So you'll see it in next week on Live Wrestling, but I'm going to send it to you, Joe. Put it in the description notes. His name is Bryce Norton. Yes. He's 2 years old. He has leukemia. He's a wrestling fan. He was John Cena for Halloween in October. And he is so cute. He's so strong. He's so badass. So there's a GoFundMe that can kind of help with his stuff, obviously. But also, we want to like increase awareness because obviously, you know, CCW is not the biggest company in America. You know, the WWE is and AEW is. And it's a little wrestling fan who is just so awesome. And his father does graphics. So he has a really cool shirt you can buy. Again, I'll put the I'll text you the link, put it in the notes. But you'll see some of our guys next week on a live. And we're trying to raise some money for him, but also, you know, just awareness to see, you know, make sure that he's okay. Luckily, they caught the leukemia a little earlier than they caught it before he had a lot of symptoms. So there's a fight, you know, but he's going through chemotherapy and all that type of stuff. So Bryce Norton, you rock, kid.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All of our thoughts and prayers with you, Bryce. And I'll be making sure I order my shirt for him to make sure I support the cause. And we'll be posting up links for everybody to take a look at all over our social media and our personal.
And his dad made a shirt for for Orlando Cologne. He made Orlando Cologne's merch and some cool shit like that. His dad's pretty his dad loves wrestling. Obviously, you know, you don't have a 2-year-old who loves wrestling unless your dad loves wrestling. But yeah, check it out. It's really awesome.
Yeah. You definitely want to get your kids involved with this amazing sport. It really brings families together. I collect my belts and my pops and,
yes,
my son has his own belts. He has about 4 belts already and, the life size belt, the big ones, you know, I make sure and get the good ones for him. But yeah, man, Bryce, our thoughts are with you, buddy. And, you know, so we're going to be, posting everything up for you guys. And, I want to thank Nelio Costa for coming on tonight. I was told to, make sure you guys follow Vinicius Fights
on Instagram or on Twitter. On Twitter is kind of a goofball. On Instagram, he's like serious or whatever.
Yeah. And then, I was grabbed by the neck as I was walking into my house and said, "Promote it." And I was like, "Yes, sir." And I walked. I don't know who touched me. I don't know who grabbed me. I was a little nervous. I just ran inside and went pee, and then I got on the show. ladies and gentlemen.
Make it to the bathroom?
I didn't make it to the bathroom. The shit out of me.
He's always in the bathroom. Did you see that guy's diet? He's always in the bathroom.
Oh, dude, 2 gallons of water every day, baby.
Taco Bell every night? Always in the bathroom?
No, Jesus. Cut me some slack, man. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been the Wrestling Paradox Podcast. MNJ Ecological 305-697-2258. Make sure you guys follow CCWFL on Twitter. If you guys want to become a professional wrestler in the South Florida region, CCW is the place to go. Will Austin, thank you so much for joining us this evening for the second round inside the Paradox. I'm sure we will be seeing you for a third time.
Always saddle up. I'm taking you guys to the top. It's going to be a long but bumpy road.
Saddle up. We are going to the top. Yes, sir. We will be, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be releasing the next block of the Sensational Six of the interviews that we got coming up. Next week, we got Dr. Eric Christopher.
He's awesome.
I was going to say, Nelio, do you have something for me, man? Because I just feel like that interview is going to be amazing.
Yeah, he's great. He really is great. He's a smart dude, really smart dude.
He's awesome, man. He made our poster for us. He's awesome, man. I had to pay him a lot of money
for
the poster.
Yeah, K-Fang.
I paid this guy a lot of money for this interview, man. I'm promoting him. Okay.
Should take this guy nowhere.
K-Fang.
Jesus.
Dr. Eric Christopher next week on the Paradox. That show is actually gonna be shot on Wednesday, not Tuesday. That show is gonna be shot on Wednesday. His schedule is very popular and very busy, so it's hard to get.
Apparently.
He's like a shoot psychiatrist, dude.
He is.
And the stuff he listens to all day, dude. He's like, he takes sessions at night and stuff. He's crazy. I don't know what he's doing.
Session after, sir.
He's like, hypnotizing ladies. I don't know what he's doing.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nelio Costa, Will Austin, thank you so much. And we will see you guys next week.